Good afternoon and welcome to Alpari UK's afternoon market update. My name's James Hughes, Chief Market Analyst at Alpari UK. Going to look at those major stories which are moving financial markets today, and it's not necessarily too many stories which are moving financial markets. We've got a lot of national holidays around the world, mainly Memorial Day in the US, which means there's quite a lack of volume around these markets today. But when you do get that lack of volume, you tend to get a degree of volatility. And you'd think so far today we'd have that little bit of volatility, but it turns out we actually haven't had that either. We are looking at a pretty quiet day, pretty close ranges on a lot of these markets. The FTSE 100 was higher by around 50 odd points earlier on today, only higher by around 20 points now, so it's paired some of those gains from earlier on. The CAC and the DAX both negative, haven't necessarily come back into positive territory. Only down by around 14, 15 points. So again, not necessarily too much, not necessarily a big range either. And it's one of those things where when the US markets do tend to close, European markets do tend to calm down, and you don't tend to get that sort of volume that you usually do when all markets are trading. And that, of course, surprising when you look at the major stories around the world financially are being dominated by the Eurozone and what's going on in terms of Greece and Spain and a lot of these countries which are struggling in the Euro area. Now, of course, some of those stories, even though it's a day where we are lacking a little bit of news flow around these markets, we have got a few stories moving, and one of those stories is from over the weekend, and it's to do with the Greece election. Now, this Greek election comes on June the 17th, but there's now beginning to be a little bit of a political favour for, and a lot of the electorate in Greece looking like they're favouring staying within the Eurozone. You've really got two sides to this story in Greece. You've got the far left party who wants to get into power, but also wants to not put in any austerity measures, any of those plans that were put forward by the ECB, the IMF, and some of those stipulations to getting a bailout. They do not want to take on any of those and do not want to input any more austerity measures. Now, what the Chancellor in Germany has said, she's come out and said, well, if you don't want to put those in, you cannot be in the Eurozone. Now, what we're seeing in Greece is a vote, really, to whether you stay in the Eurozone or whether you don't, whether you vote for this far left-hand party or whether you don't vote for them, you vote for the other alternatives. And there are two other parties in Greece who are taking the majority of the vote now, and it looks like around 80% of Greek people are favouring staying within the Eurozone rather than coming out of it. Now, at the moment for Greece, this is a bigger issue either way. It doesn't necessarily matter either way, because either way, the country is going to be struggling, and that is the be-all and end-all behind that. But the problem about them coming out of the Eurozone is then this so-called figure of a 1 trillion euro bill that the rest of the world is going to have to foot. So we're still going to have to wait until June. We're still waiting for a lot of this uncertainty. June 17th is when this election is, so that's going to be the key time to look out for. Now, there have been some other stories around the world, and we're looking at these Bankia shares in Spain. Yet again, the fourth largest bank in Spain, now pretty much state-owned by the Spanish government, asking for another 19 billion euros in bailout money, and this is not necessarily too much of a surprise. But what this story is doing is pushing up Spanish bond prices, and that's it, or Spanish bond yields, and that's the big issue. Of course, when you get up to close to that 7% level, which everyone talks about, Greece got there, that was the signal for their first bailout. Italy got there, and there was a lot of panic around the government. They did lose a government in Italy because of that, and again, with Spain edging towards those 7% levels, it's not necessarily looking too good. So it's going to have to be some big moves in Spain to help this turn around. But at the moment, the fears and worries, and of course uncertainties surrounding Greece, this Bankia problem in Spain, is really affecting everyone and sentiment in the Eurozone, and is pushing these bond yields higher. So that's a big issue for the Eurozone, is trying to keep these bond yields lower. But how they do that when all this uncertainty is around, of course, is another big question. Now, I mean, looking towards the rest of this week, obviously today we do have US markets closed, so there isn't any trading, there's no economic data, but it's a big week for economic data. Later in the week, we've got the non-farm payrolls coming out of the US, that US labor report, the jobs report. Now, of course, the unemployment remains the number one barometer in seeing what economies are doing and how economies are performing, and there is a feeling that the US economy is performing better than others. It's starting to leave their problems behind them and almost leave those problems of the Eurozone behind them as well, and continue to perform. Now, recently the payroll numbers and the jobs numbers haven't necessarily been too good in the US, and another month where we see a negative number may get people worrying that the US maybe aren't in the positive position that they expect them to be. But of course, we'll have to wait until later in the week. We've got that non-farm payroll on Friday, the unemployment figure and the jobs report on Friday, and then the ADP number comes out on Wednesday. That's the other section of the jobs report. And you've got initial jobless claims on Thursday. So as we get Wednesday, Thursday, Friday this week, it's going to be a big week week dominated by those employment numbers in the US. But while they're closed today, we are lacking volume, we are lacking any news flow, so we're lacking that bit of volatility that the markets look for. At the moment, market's not doing too much. The FTSE in positive territory, but the rest of Europe in negative territory. Thank you very much for listening. My name's James Hughes, Chief Market Analyst at Alpari UK.